Students, welcome to NEET Wizard. Here the audio notes for digestion and absorption. Food is one of the basic requirements of all living organism. The major components of our food are carbohydrates, proteins and fats, vitamins and minerals are also required in small quantities. Food provides energy and organic materials for growth and repair of tissues. The water we take in plays an important role in metabolic process and also prevents dehydration of the body. Biomacromolecules in food cannot be utilized by our body in their original form. They have to be broken down and converted into simple substances in the digestive system. These process of conversion of complex food substances to simple absorbable forms is called digestion and is carried out by our digestive system by mechanical and biochemical methods. General organization of the human digestive system. Digestive system. The human digestive system consists of the alimentary canal and the associated glands. Alimentary canal. The alimentary canal begins with an interior opening, the mouth, and it opens but out posteriorly through the anus. The mouth leads to the buccal cavity or oral cavity. The oral cavity has a number of teeth and a muscular tongue. Each tooth is embedded in a socket of jawbone. This type of attachment is called thecodont. Majority of mammals, including human beings, forms two sets of teeth during their life. A set of temporary milk or deciduous teeth replaced by a set of permanent or adult teeth. This type of dentition is called diphyodont. An adult human has 32 permanent teeth, which are of four different types, heterodont dentition, namely incisor, canine, premolars and molars. Arrangement of teeth in each half of the upper and lower jaw in the order incisor, canine, premolar and molar is represented by a dental formula, which in human is 2-1-2-3 by 2-1-2-3. The hard shaving surface of the teeth made up of enamel helps in the mastication of food. The tongue is a freely movable muscular organ attached to the floor of the oral cavity by the frenulum. The upper surface of the tongue has small projections called papilla, some of which bear test buds. The oral cavity leads into a short pharynx, which serves as common passage for food and air. The esophagus and the trachea windpipe opens into the pharynx. A cartilaginous flap called epiglottis prevents the entry of food into the glottis. Opening of the windpipe during swallowing. The esophagus is a thin long tube which extends posteriorly, passing through the neck, thorax and diaphragm, and leads to a J-shaped bag-like structure called stomach. A muscular sphincter, gastroesophageal, regulates the opening of esophagus into the stomach. The stomach, located in the upper left portion of the abdominal cavity, has three major parts: a cardiac portion into which the esophagus opens, a fundic region, and a pyloric portion, which opens into the first part of small intestine. Small intestine is distinguishable into three regions: a U-shaped duodenum, a long-coiled middle portion jejunum, and a highly coiled ileum. The opening of the stomach into the duodenum is guarded by the pyloric sphincter. Ileum opens into large intestine. It consists of cecum, colon and rectum. Cecum is a small blind sac which hosts some symbiotic microorganism, a narrow finger-like tubular projection. The vermiform appendix, which is a vestigial organ, arises from the cecum. The cecum opens into the colon. The colon is divided into three parts, an ascending, a transverse and a descending part. The descending part opens into the rectum, which opens out through the anus. The wall of alimentary canal from esophagus to rectum possesses four layers, namely serosa, muscularis, submucosa and mucosa. Serosa is the outermost layer and is made up of a thin mesothelium, epithelium of visceral organs with some connective tissues. Muscularis is formed by smooth muscles, usually arranged into an inner circular and in outer longitudinal layer. An oblique muscles layer may be present in some regions. The submucosal layer is formed of loose connective tissues containing nerves, blood and lymph vessels. In duodenum, glands are also present in submucosa. The innermost layer lining the lumen of the alimentary canal is the mucosa. These layers form irregular folds, rugae, in the stomach, and small finger-like foldings called villi in the small intestine. The cells lining the villi produce numerous microscopic projections called microvilli, giving a brush border appearance. These modifications increase the surface area enormously. Villi are supplied with a network of capillaries and a large lymph vessels called the lacteal. Mucosal epithelium has goblet cells which secrete mucus that help in lubrication. Mucosa also form glands in the stomach, gastric glands, and crypts in between the bases of villi. In the intestine, crypts of Leber Cohen, all the four layers show modification in different parts of the alimentary canal. Now, digestive glands. The digestive glands associated with the alimentary canal include the salivary glands, the liver, and the pancreas. Saliva is mainly produced by three pairs of salivary glands: the parotid, cheek, the submaxillary, submandibular, lower jaw, and the sublingual, below the tongue. These glands, situated outside the buccal cavity, secrete salivary juice into the buccal cavity. Liver is the largest gland of the body, bagging about 1.200 to 1.500 kilograms in an adult human. It is situated in the abdominal cavity just below the diaphragm and Hayes two lobes. The hepatic lobules are the structural and functional units of liver, containing hepatic cells arranged in the form of cords. Each lobule is covered by a thin connective tissue sheath called the Gleason's capsule. The bile secreted by the hepatic cells passes through the hepatic ducts and is stored and concentrated in a thin muscular sac called the gallbladder. The duct of gallbladder, cystic duct, along with the hepatic duct from the liver, form the common bile duct. The bile duct and the pancreatic duct open together into the duodenum as the common hepatopancreatic duct, which is guarded by a sphincter called the sphincter of Oddi. The pancreas is a compound both exocrine and endocrine, elongated organ situated between the limbs of the U-shaped duodenum. The exocrine portion secretes an alkaline pancreatic juice containing enzymes, and the endocrine portion secretes hormones, insulin and glucagon. Now, digestion of food. The process of digestion is accomplished by mechanical and chemical process. The buccal cavity performs two major functions: mastication of food and facilitation of swallowing. The teeth and the tongue, with the help of saliva, masticate and mix up the food thoroughly. Mucosa in saliva helps in lubricating and adhering the masticated food particles into a bolus. The bolus then conveyed into the pharynx and then into the esophagus by swallowing or deglutition. The bolus further passes down through the esophagus by successive waves of muscular contractions called peristalsis. The gastroesophageal sphincter controls the passage of food into the stomach. The saliva secreted into the oral cavity contains electrolyte, sodium, potassium, chlorine, bicarbonates, and enzymes. Salivary amylase and the lysozyme, the chemical process of digestion is initiated in the oral cavity by the hydrolytic action of the carbohydrates splitting enzymes. The salivary amylase, about 30% of starch, is hydrolyzed here by this enzyme, optimum pH 6.8, into a disaccharide maltose. Lysozyme present in saliva acts as an antibacterial agent that prevents infection. The mucosa of stomach has gastric glands. Gastric glands have three major types of cells, namely mucus neck cells which secrete mucus, peptic or chief cells which secrete the proenzyme pepsinogen, and parietal or auxiliary cells which secrete ACL and intrinsic factors, factors essential for absorption of vitamin B12. The stomach stores the food for 4 to 5 hours. The food mixes thoroughly with the acidic gastric juice of the stomach by the churning movements of its muscular wall and is called the chyme. The proenzyme pepsinogen on exposure to hydrochloric acid gets converted into the active Enzyme pepsin, the proteic enzyme of the stomach. Pepsin converts proteins into proteases and peptones peptides. The mucus and bicarbonates present in the gastric juice play an important role in lubrication and protection of the mucosal epithelium from exocortation by the highly concentrated hydrochloric acid. HCl provides the acidic pH, pH 1.8, optimal for pepsins. Renin is a proteolytic enzyme found in gastric juice of infants, which help in the digestion of milk proteins. Small amounts of lipases are also secreted by gastric glands. Various types of movements are generated by the muscularis layers of the small intestine. These movements help in a through mixing up of the food with various secretions in the intestine and thereby facilitate digestion. The bile, pancreatic juice and the intestinal juice are the secretions released into the small intestine. Pancreatic juice and bile are released through the hepatopancreatic duct. The pancreatic juice contains inactive enzymes trypsinogen, chymotrypsinogen, procarboxypeptidases, amylases, lipases and nucleases. Trypsinogen is activated by an enzyme enterokinase secreted by the intestinal mucosa into active trypsin, which in turn activates the other enzyme in the pancreatic juice. The bile released into the duodenum contains bile pigments bilirubin and bilirubin. Bile salts, cholesterol and phospholipids, but no enzymes. Bile helps in emulsification of fats, for example breaking down of the fats into very small micelles. Bile also activates lipases. The intestinal mucosal epithelium has goblet cells which secrete mucus. The secretion of the brush border cells of the mucosa along with the secretions of the goblet cells constitute the intestinal juice or succus entericus. This juice contains a variety of enzymes like disaccharides, example maltase, dipeptidase, lipases, nucleosidase, etc. The mucus along with the bicarbonates from the pancreas protects the intestinal mucosa from acid as well as provide an alkaline medium pH 7.8 for enzymatic activities. Submucosal glands, Brunner's glands, also help in these. Proteins, proteases and peptones, partially hydrolyzed proteins in the chyme reaching the intestine, are acted upon by the proteolytic enzyme of pancreatic juice as given below. Now you can see proteins, peptones and proteases after the reaction of carboxypeptide is converted into dipeptides. Carbohydrates in the chyme are hydrolyzed by pancreatic amylase into disaccharides, polysaccharides and disaccharides. Fats are broken down by lipases with the help of bile into di and monoglycerides. Nucleases in the pancreatic juice acts on nucleic acid to form nucleotides and nucleosides. The enzymes in the succus entericus act on the end products of the above reactions to form the respective simple absorber forms. These final steps in digestion occur very close to the mucosal epithelial cells of the intestine. The breakdown of biomacromolecules mentioned above occur in the duodenum region of the small intestine. The simple substances thus formed are absorbed in the jejunum and ileum regions of the small intestine. The undigested and unabsorbed substances are passed on the large intestine. No significant digestive activity occurs in the large intestine. The functional of large intestines are absorption of some water, minerals and certain drugs, secretion of mucus which help in adhering the waste and digested particles together and lubricating it for an easy passage. The undigested and absorbed substances called feces enters into the cecum of the large intestine through ileocecal valve, which prevents the backflow of the fecal matter. It is temporarily stored in the rectum till defecation. The activities of the gastrointestinal tract are under neural and hormonal control for proper coordination of different parts. The sight, smell and or the presence of food in the oral cavity can stimulate the secretion of saliva. Gastric and intestinal secretions are also similarly stimulated by the neural glands. The muscular activities of different parts of the alimentary canal can be moderated by neural mechanism, both local and through CNS. Hormonal control of the secretion of digestive juices is carried out by the local hormones produced by the gastric juice and intestinal mucosa. Absorption of digested products. Absorption is the process by which the end products of digestion pass through the internal mucosa into the blood or lymph. It is carried out by passive, active, or facilitated transport mechanism. Small amounts of monosaccharides like glucose amino acids and some of electrolytes like chloride ions are generally absorbed by the simple diffusion. The passage of these substances into the blood depends upon the concentration gradients. However, some of the substances like fructose and some amino acids are absorbed with the help of the carrier ions like sodium. This mechanism is called the facilitated transport. Transport of water depends upon the osmotic gradient. Active transport occurs against the concentration gradient and hence requires energy. Various nutrients like amino acids, monosaccharides like glucose, electrolytes like sodium are absorbed into the blood by this mechanism. Fatty acid and glycerol being insoluble cannot be absorbed into the blood. They are first incorporated into small droplets called the micelles which move into the intestinal mucosa. They are reformed into a very small protein-coated fat globules called the chylomicrons which are transported into the lymph vessels lacteals in the villi. These lymph vessels ultimately release the absorbed substances into the bloodstream. Absorption of substances takes place in different parts of the alimentary canal like mouth, stomach, small intestine and large intestine. However, maximum absorption occurs in small intestine. Now you can see mouth, certain drugs coming in contact with the mucosa of mouth and lower side of the tongue are absorbed into the blood capillaries lining them. Stomach, absorption of water, simple sugars and alcohol etc. takes place. In the small intestine, principal organ for absorption of nutrients, the digestion is completed here and the final products of digestion such as glucose, fructose, fatty acids, glycerol and amino acids are absorbed through the mucosa into the bloodstream and lymph. Large intestine, absorption of water, some minerals and drugs takes place. The absorbed substances finally reach the tissues which utilize them for their activities. This process is called assimilation. The digestive waste is solidified into coherent feces in the rectum, initiate a neural reflex causing an urge or desire for its removal. The ejection of feces to the outside through the anal opening, defecation is a voluntary process and is carried out by a mass peristaltic movement. Disorder of digestive system. The inflammation of the intestinal tract is the most common ailment due to bacterial or viral infections. The infections are also caused by the parasites of the intestine like tapeworm, roundworm, threadworm, hookworm, pinworm, etc. Jaundice. The liver is affected, skin and eyes turn yellow due to deposit of bile pigments. Vomiting. It is the ejection of stomach contents through the mouth. This reflex action is controlled by the vomit center in the medulla. A fling of nausea precedes vomiting. Diarrhea. The abnormal frequency of bowel movement and increased liquidity of the fecal discharge is known as diarrhea. It reduces the absorption of food. Constipation. In constipation, the feces are retained within the rectum as the bowel movements occur irregularly. Indigestion. In this condition, the food is not properly digested, leading a feeling of fullness. The cause of indigestion are inadequate enzyme secretion, anxiety, food poisoning, overeating, and spicy food. Now the chapter digestion and absorption is over.